Hackers, welcome to a very special episode of Not SNS Please, but we're going to be doing the TMI challenge with our good friend KittyCallMeKat. She challenged us to do the thing over on her channel, so we're going to be doing it here while we play some duck game. She's going to be putting her own spin on the questions. So Kat, why don't you take it away?
Hey everybody, this is KittyCallMeKat, and I'm here to pick your brain while you game. I'm here to do the TMI challenge with these lucky lads at Slack and Slash. I'm going to add in a few of my own questions, but I will be asking the odd-numbered questions from the TMI challenge. I did the even-numbered ones, and I challenged them to do the odd-numbered ones. So that's what we're doing today.
Thank you for giving that bit
of
information.
Notice I'm also wearing the same shirt that I was wearing before, so you all know that it's not 2 months later that we're doing this. It's the same day. We filmed this all on the same day. My challenge and their challenge.
Oh, jeez. Yeah, that's exactly what happened.
Okay. Are you
so, yeah,
guys
yeah, we're ready to go whenever you are.
Okay. Okay. First question. What are you wearing?
Andy is wearing
I'm wearing bird shirt.
A beautiful dad bird shirt.
Okay.
And I'm wearing a Pikmin Mario t-shirt smash-up that I got on, I think, Shirt Punch or Ripped Apparel,
okay.
One of those sites.
Cool.
Free, hashtag not an ad.
Yes, you must say you're not being sponsored by them.
Not yet. What's up, Shirt Punch? Hit me up.
You think Shirt Punch has sponsorship money, bro?
Yeah, dude.
They're not Warner Brothers. Oh, God.
Okay. Have ever had a terrible breakup?
I mean, who hasn't, right?
Right.
Ooh, I think I got the terrible breakup market cornered, though.
Yeah, Andy Brown definitely does.
I dated a girl
for 5 years, and then she just moved to New Zealand and stopped talking to me.
Oh.
Yeah, so that's a real bad breakup.
You guys were going to try to do the long distance thing, and then
We tried, and then she just, like, noped out of there.
Just ghosted you.
Yeah.
Sorry, man.
I got a trombone.
Oh, God. Yeah, sorry, Kat. Andy just got a trombone and tried to use it as a weapon, so.
It works.
It broke the tension. It's good. Yeah, my breakup story is far less interesting.
What?
It was just a breakup because, you know, relationships end.
Right. Okay. Excellent. Excellent story.
Yeah, super interesting.
How much do you weigh?
Andy?
200 pounds?
So
I think I'm going to take. I think I'm at like 195 now. 190.
It is the TMI challenge, so.
I just don't know. Yeah, it's like I might be 200 at this point. I'm fat. Whatever.
Any piercings?
I have my nose pierced and my ear is pierced, but I don't wear a ring in it anymore.
Okay.
Andy?
I do not have any piercings.
Yeah. Okay. Pete, we learned in your interview with me a while ago that you were a big Pokemon fan.
That's for sure.
So I wanted to ask you how many dead bodies you've found walking around playing Pokemon Go?
I mean, I've been playing the game for like a week now, so oh my God, I'm bodying you, Andy.
You really are.
Yeah, so I've been playing Pokemon Go for a week now, and I think I found like 12 dead bodies. But to be fair, I have been playing in cemeteries a lot, so I don't know if that counts. Andy? Oh, Andy can't play Pokemon
I can't play
Go.
Pokemon Go because my phone is a heathen and won't run it.
Oh, no. Okay, moving on. Favorite show?
Favorite show?
Mm-hmm.
Parks and Rec.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, God, everything turned into swords.
That was a sword bomb.
I'm into 30 Rock myself.
Those are both great shows.
And it makes sense. It's like basically our relationship. I'm definitely the Amy Poehler to his Tina Fey.
Oh. Besties.
I'm both prettier and funnier?
Damn. I mean, that's accurate. Like, not for them, but for you and me. That's what you get for talking shit, Andy. You kill yourself in duck game.
Yeah. Throw a sword at the wall and it hits me in the head.
Okay, something you miss.
Something I miss. You know what? I'm gonna go for like the sad angle. I miss my dog, Buddy. He passed away like 2 years ago. I still miss that guy. He was a good dog.
I'm gonna go with the way more irreverent angle. I miss the Ghostbusters high C flavor.
Yo, they brought it back. Yeah, you can get it right now. We should go get some after this. what was that shit called? Ecto-cooler? Yeah, no, that's yep. Totally back.
Both excellent answers. How old are you?
23.
I'm also 23.
Okay.
Oh, jeez.
And nobody quality... likes us. Oh, what? Say what?
Solid Blink-182 reference, bro.
I'm sorry, Kat. What'd you say?
Well, I couldn't hear you either.
Oh, I just made a Blink-182 joke.
Oh.
I said nobody liked us because we were 23.
Oh, I get it. I got you.
It's hot topical references. You know, just put out
an album. No, really. Yeah, really on trend right now, P.
Really, yeah. I'm really up on the trends these days.
Quality you look for in a partner.
Andy's gorgeous beard. That's what I look for in a partner.
I look for having the sides of their head shaped like Pete.
Nice. So obviously we're a perfect match.
All right. Favorite actor?
Andy, you go first. You're a movie guy.
That's like a loaded question.
Yeah.
I guess gun to my head while I'm playing Duck Game, I go... Ray Fiennes?
Okay. I mean, I'm gonna go with like a way more like boring answer, but I would say like my favorite serious actor is probably Leonardo DiCaprio.
Oh, man.
Like, he's a legit actor. I'm really a fan of his work. I'm a basic bitch, what can I say?
Leo!
Yeah, I named my Squirtle after him in my Pokemon Blue playthrough because he had just won his Oscar and I was happy for him.
Okay. Can I take my answer back and change it to the bear from The Revenant?
Yes.
This is my favorite actor.
Oh my god.
Okay, loud music or soft music?
Depends on the mood.
Yeah.
Man, now I can't have a good answer. Just gotta pick one. probably loud music, I guess.
Yeah.
I mean, duck under my head. I'm going to go loud music too, but.
Okay, this is a fun one. How long does it take you to shower?
I mean, it depends. Like, if I just need to shower because I need to get ready, I can do it in like 10 minutes. But if I'm taking my time, like 20 minutes maybe.
Yeah, 5-10 minutes.
Oh, the TMI challenge.
I didn't mean it dirty like that, Kat. Gross. It's me like, damn, I just like taking a shower.
Ever been in a physical fight?
Yeah, like three times in my life.
Yeah. You been in a fight, Pete?
Like, I was like really young. I got in a fight with somebody in middle school because...
Over a Pokemon card.
Nah, he like, the dude just like... He did this thing, like, where he grabbed a pen, right, and rubbed it really hard in a pencil and then burned my arm. Oh. And then, like, pushed me into a wall in the hallway after lunch the same day. And I just, like, put him in a headlock until two teachers came and broke it up. So that's not super exciting.
I support you.
And then
you
the other
that.
Fight story I have is me and a friend beat up these two kids that were picking on his little brother at a park. So that's a little more heroic. I come off better in that one.
I support both of those.
I was just defending myself, you know? And then the little guy. That's good stuff.
Yeah.
Andy Brown?
I did karate for a long time, so I've, like, been in karate fights, but not in, like, real life fights. If that makes sense.
You don't want to fuck with Andy Brown, though. Like, he's a legit black belt, and I made the mistake of trying to tackle him once in, like, the ninth grade, and ended up flipped on my ass and never did that again.
Are you a black belt?
Yes.
Excellent.
Now I'm a dead duck.
Now you're a dead duck.
You're a dying duck. Okay, so the next question is turn-offs.
Turn-offs?
Turn-offs.
Okay.
Just, that's the whole question?
Yes. Well, the previous one is turn-ons.
Oh, okay.
So then this one is turn-offs.
I would say my biggest turn-off is just, like, is being shallow. Is anyone who, like, shallowly enjoys, and not even necessarily just, like, valuing people for their appearance, but even if they're shallow in the way that they appreciate things. You know, I like people that think deeply about stuff.
Mm-hmm.
My only really big turnoff is Confederate flag stuff.
That's it. Just like, otherwise we're fine.
You are lucky then that you do not live down here in Georgia.
Oh, yeah. 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 I'm sure Kat sees a lot of that.
I see a lot of that. There's quite a lot of it.
Oh, God.
Okay. Next question. Fears.
Fears?
Fears.
Birds. Yeah. Andy's actually legitimately really afraid of birds.
Yeah, birds freak me out. I don't like being around them.
Yep.
So, like, when you're walking outside, do you run if one's near you?
I don't run, but, like, I have crossed the street to avoid walking past a group of pigeons before.
I think my favorite Andy Brown has a bird phobia story is we were in New York City a couple of years ago to go see the Bouncing Souls and the Gaslight Anthem play together. Mm-hmm. And like at this point, Andy and I had been friends and bandmates for like almost 10 years, probably over 10 years at that point. Mm-hmm. And I didn't know he was afraid of birds. I had just like never gotten that piece of information somehow. Mm-hmm. And we're in the Penn Station, train station. And this bird, like a pigeon, just floops over, like flies over us. And Andy,
you said you use floops.
I tried to say swoops, and it just came out floops, swoops and flies. And that was funny. And then it flies over us, and Andy ducks like he heard a bomb go off, and like just hit the fucking deck, and it was ridiculous.
Wait, Andy. So has something ever happened with a bird?
Not really. I mean, I've been harassed by seagulls before, but who hasn't?
Right.
It's just, I don't know.
Okay.
Birds weird me out.
Okay. All right. Pete, what is your fear?
I think the only thing I'm, like, pathologically afraid of is spiders. And I had, like, one experience with one where I tried to, like, scoop it up off the wall in my bedroom when I was a child, and it, like, jumped on me and bit me.
Oh.
So that, like, really freaked me out. but beyond that, like, I don't do too well in heights. Like, if I'm in a height that is easy to fall off of, that I get, like, a little vertigo.
Yeah. Okay, I feel you in that.
Yeah, pretty generic fears, honestly.
Birds and spiders. Last time you said you loved someone...
Right now. Yeah. I love you, Andy Brown.
Oh, that's a good one.
And you're a dead fucking duck.
Okay, last book you read. Not the current book. The last book.
The last book. What is the last book I read? I guess it was Saga? It's a graphic novel by... Why can't I remember who wrote that?
Brian K. Vaughan.
Brian K. Vaughan, okay.
Yeah, that's funny, because I know you know that.
I know that, too. I just couldn't think of it.
Brain fart, playing duck game.
Winning duck game.
Let me think. Yeah, because like, if you're not counting current reads, then I guess it was The Road was the last book I read.
Some Cormac McCarthy.
The Road?
Yeah, The Road by Cormac McCarthy. It's a post-apocalyptic story about, like, the world ends, and it follows this man and his son, like, years after the world's ended, and everything's really desolate. It's a really great read.
Cool.
I started reading it in college, and then didn't finish it, and finished it, like, up about a month or two ago, I think.
Okay.
It's a good read.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Okay, last show you watched.
Actually, I was watching, the original Pokemon series on Netflix with Thompson and my girlfriend Alexa.
Cool. Okay.
I was watching the new Match Game on ABC. Because game shows.
Is it good?
Yeah, actually. Alec Baldwin making fun of celebrities is never not going
to be. Oh, Alec Baldwin's the host? That's cool.
Yes, he is.
I'm sure you love that.
Oh, I do.
Oh, God.
Okay. I don't know what happened there, but you're dead now.
I don't know either.
I'm gonna insert this one in because I was asked it and I didn't know what it was. But the question is, I guess, what is your favorite one true pairing?
One true pairing?
Do you know what that means?
Like a couple?
Yeah.
It's like a, I think it's like a...
Like a famous couple or like a couple in a book or a couple in a show or a character.
Okay, like the thing that you ship. Okay.
I didn't pull that.
I don't. Who do I ship? Like, who do I ship hard?
Kurosami.
Thompson is behind the camera and he says Kurosami.
I'm all about Pewie.
Pewie, that's a good one. I'm gonna go with Poke Shipping, Ash and Misty. I was always into that as a kid, and it's on my brain since I was just watching it.
Okay.
Yeah. Right. Oh God, I don't really.
You know, like, do you have a serious answer?
Is it a cop out if I pick one that's like a pair on the show?
No, that's fine.
And just like talk about how adorable Ruby and Sapphire are.
No, that works.
That's perfect. Yeah,
they're the best.
Yeah, that's great.
Okay, good. I inserted that one. You're welcome. The relationship between you and the person you last texted.
I think I last texted Thompson or Ozzy, so I love those guys. They're on my YouTube channel.
Okay.
The last person I texted was my mom.
She's okay.
Nah, she's cool.
No, yeah, shout out to Patty Brown. She's a great lady.
Okay, name a place you want to visit.
You know, I've never been out of the country, so I'd love to go to Europe. It really doesn't matter where. And there's a couple countries I'd love to see, but
okay.
That's a cop out, but whatever.
Like, which countries do you want to see in Europe?
I'd love to go to, I mean, London, France, Germany. Pretty much anywhere that I'm not afraid that I'll get like murdered, I'm down to go to. You know?
Okay.
I don't want to go to like deep Eastern Europe and go to like Romania or anything, but
hey man. You could learn Romanian.
I'm allowed to say that Romania is scary because I'm Hungarian and they're like basically next door neighbors.
Oh, so I'm allowed to say my next door neighbors are scary?
Yeah.
Okay. Because my next door neighbors are kind of scary.
Your next door neighbor's a cop, isn't he?
No, that's the guy who lives around the corner.
Oh, okay.
My next door neighbors are like a rotating cast of drug addicts who rent the house behind me.
Nice, that's legit.
Yeah. As far as places I want to visit.
I was going to say, what was this question? Where did this start?
I've never been to San Francisco, and I really loved it.
Awesome.
Oh, I haven't been there either.
What was that, Kat?
I said I haven't been there either, but everybody says it's great.
Yeah, it's a lovely city.
Yeah. The next question is, do you have a crush? I love these questions.
Do I have a crush? Yes. It's my boo, Lex Nova. What up, babe?
Same.
Your crush is my girlfriend too.
Same.
That's legit. She's cute.
My crush is Pete's girlfriend.
I'm sure
everybody
Mary
has
will
a
really
crush on
that.
Pete's girlfriend. Okay.
But Mary would have to watch our YouTube channel for that to be a problem. So I think we're fine.
I mean, you speak the true.
Hey man, well, like I wouldn't expect anyone, like my girlfriend spends enough time with me in real life. Why the fuck would she want to watch me on the internet play video games? She has the front row seat to that every night. Anyway.
Awkward pause. Last time you were insulted.
I'm sorry, what?
Last time you were insulted.
Insulted?
She said insulted, you goofy-eared motherfucker.
Thanks, Thompson.
No, I can't say that I remember. I mean, literally every time I play a video game with Andy, it happens.
Okay.
So.
Yeah, you had to tell me to be nice to him, right?
Yeah, right, Kat? You remember, you had to tell Andy to stop bullying me on our own
series.
Oh,
is that Andy?
That is Andy.
Leave Pete alone.
Hashtag leave Pete alone.
Is that like leave Britney alone?
Yeah, it's exactly like that.
Leave Pete alone.
Oh, my duck's dead.
Wait, did everybody answer that question?
Yeah, you didn't answer.
I honestly don't remember. Like,
all right, you're a fucking dork. There
okay,
you go.
Right now.
Okay. What instruments do you play?
I play drums well. I dabble on the guitar, the keyboards, and other, like,
guitar knockoff instruments that have similar chord structures.
Okay.
I play the saxophone well. I dabble in guitar and ukulele now.
Ooh. You got a nice uke.
Yeah. Yeah, his sister bought him a sweet Steven Universe ukulele for your birthday. Yeah, for my birthday. It's cool.
It's very cool. There's the last girl that I interviewed, she's Hungarian, and she plays the ukulele in some of her videos, and she was playing a Radiohead song on the ukulele, and it sounded really cool. Okay. Last sport you played.
Oof. I don't know, like, t-ball and, like, this fucking when I was six. I think I played some football like a couple weeks back.
Okay.
Nothing like serious. I haven't played a sport seriously since I played soccer in sixth grade.
You were in track.
Oh, I forgot about that.
For a year. That was a thing.
That was a
thing. When we were like freshmen. And then, you know, you were like too busy being a rock star and a theater nerd.
I was a theater nerd. That's like a sport.
Yeah, I did marching band. I wasn't a sports guy.
Okay. This is a good one. Favorite chat up line.
Okay, I got one. Yo girl, you playing Pokemon Go?
Oh.
That's what I got. Yeah, that's it. That's my hotline for the kids. That's how I would meet a girl if I was single. What do you got, Andy? You're suaver than me.
I'm not that suave. I don't know.
Oh, I
didn't
say
I've ever given you this impression.
I didn't say you were suave. I said you were suaver than me.
I don't know. I'm like, I don't get hit on in bars a lot. So I don't know if you could tell that about me.
I couldn't. Look at that bird shirt. Who wouldn't want a piece of this action?
I really got nothing. Wow. I guess, you know, something like, did it hurt when you fell from heaven?
That's a oldie but a terribly.
Yes. Okay. Last time you hung out with anyone?
Right now?
Battery died.
Oh, yeah. Excellent. Okay. And then I'm adding in a last question.
All right, last question, everybody.
Okay. When we talked, Pete, I was giving Batman versus Superman a hard time, and I never saw it because I was upset about two good guys fighting each other, and you tried to convince me that it probably wouldn't be that much in the movie that they were fighting. So you actually saw it. So give us the verdict officially on Batman versus Superman.
Well, it was a terrible movie, but it wasn't because they were fighting each other, I'll tell you that much. I mean, like, I think the worst part of the whole them fighting thing is, like, it takes up almost none of the movie. So it's, like,
oh.
I don't know. It's a very small portion of it. And then they shoehorn in a bunch of other stuff that is, it's a hot mess. That movie's a hot mess. You didn't miss anything, Kat.
What are they doing the whole time, then?
Like, they fight for, like, probably a third of it. Then there's a third of it that's set up for the last big fight scene that happens in every superhero movie where they fight Doomsday and Wonder Woman shows up to kick some ass, which was admittedly pretty cool.
Okay.
I was pro Gal Gadot.
Yeah, I didn't see it. But again, everybody I know who saw it was like, she was great, the movie was bad.
Yep.
Shit.
Yeah, it's terrible. It's a really bad movie. It's not the worst superhero movie that I've ever seen, but it's the worst one in recent
memory.
Oh,
you did see Amazing Spider-Man 2, dude.
That movie's bad. Also, so is Daredevil. Green Lantern's also worse. There's plenty of movies that are worse. There's like at least three X-Men movies that are worse than that movie.
Three?
Yeah. I'm going to go out on that limb.
How did Ben Affleck do as Batman?
I liked Batfleck. It wasn't like a normal Batman. Like, it wasn't the Batman that we're necessarily used to, but I thought he did a good job. I thought he was definitely one of the saving graces of the movie.
Really?
Yeah, like, if there was anything that was good about it, he was definitely one of those things. Henry Cavill was also a fine Superman. The cast is definitely not the problem with the movie. It's the script and the directing and, like, I don't know, everything else. Let's just pick.
Okay, so then the last question is, who do you want to challenge next?
Oh shoot, I should have thought about this before right now. Crap.
Jack and Nash?
Yeah, that's a good pick. Alright, we're gonna challenge our homies Jack and Nash over on Jack and Nash on YouTube.
Jack and Nash on Jack and Nash.
Yep.
That's them.
We're friends with them because they also have an N with an apostrophe in the middle of their name.
We met on Twitter over that and that alone, and it spawned a friendship that's, you know, lasted months.
Lasted a couple tweets at each other.
Yeah, it's good stuff. But they're awesome. they're good guys.
Now you're
so
best friends.
We'll challenge them.
Okay.
Jack and Nash, we're coming for you. Do stuff.
Okay, well then I'm done. You've completed the challenge for me.
Awesome. Thank you so much for joining us, Kat.
Thank you for having me.
As always, guys, if you like this video, please give it a like, share it with a friend, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. We'll see you in the next video. And if you haven't, please go check out Kat's channel at KittyCallMeKat and give her a sub as well. Her stuff's great.
And Jack and Nash, they're cool too.
Yeah, and Jack and Nash. Shout out to those guys. Yeah. All right. Bye, guys. Bye, guys.